Some aspects of sensory tourism in the context of archaeological museums in Poznań. Whereas previous studies in tourism promote the case, current research finds a holistic approach to sight, hearing, smells, taste, and touch in order to develop effective communication with visitors and create conditions to enchant tourist experiences. Consequently, sensory aspects of tourism have recently been focused as important dimension in the process of facilitating positive tourist experiences. Among others, also the archaeological museums embrace resources rich in multisensory stimuli that are more often utilized in the planning and marketing of appealing tourist experiences. And this tendency is closely linked with one of the main trends of today's tourist, namely experience economy. And today's business, including tourism, must provide memorable events for their customers, and that memory itself becomes the product, the experience. Thus, tourists has to provide professionally prepared tourist product, strongly marked with emotion. It also resonates with what Marciano Molotti calls sensory tourism. It is a tourism more oriented to emotional and experiential aspects and less tied to contents and material aspects. What's important here is not the authenticity of the event, but the authenticity of the experience, which although repeatable at infinitum for every tourist, is always real and individual for each one of them. In this context, also an idea of a new historical culture, new historical sensitivity has to be mentioned. It causes issues specific to postmodern forms of personal contact with the past. The development of an approach to the past where sensualism dominates over intellectualized forms of contact with the past, constituting a new form of historical sensitivity, have been proposed. And it is characterized by the emphasis on the sensuous but not necessarily intellectual experience of the past, of the current visual era of human historical culture, according to Polish sociologist Andrzej Spoczynski, is dominated by nonverbal communication, images, happenings, performance. It is not the intellect, but rather the senses which play the key role in the experience of the past, allow to immerse oneself with more or less success in the past. And in many archaeological museums in Poland, significant changes are underway. There are not changes in the planned curricula or extensive theoretical foundation, but rather the effect of the practical adaptation of certain institutions to new socio-political and in particular economic condition, especially market demands and visitor experiences and visitor expectations, as well as the need to be competitive. And these trends will be illustrated by selected examples. My presentation is not a systematic study, systematic analysis, but reveals some trends in archaeological museums and in archaeological expositions, namely significant changes in exhibition strategies and forms of exposition that have been taking place, but also I'll mention some words about educational projects. And often they are connected with commercialization of museum institutions, and I will put under analysis trends in Polish archaeological expositions, which are due to many factors, mainly the realization of new museological assumption and new museum trends. And there are consequences, the necessity has arisen to take the culturally shaped expectations of today's audience into account, as well as the need to be competitive on the market. And new scientific structures where there is a high degree of interactive displays allowing visitors to have direct contact with exhibits through multimedia have been of significant influence in this respect. As for example, the Copernicus Science Center in Warsaw, the Warsaw Rising Museum, the Museum of the History of Polish Jews, and also under construction is the Museum of the Second World War. It can be claimed that this new institution have revolutionized thinking about exhibition museum programs and frequency of visitors, as well as the possibility of interaction, emotional engagement, and co-creation of museum content. This changed variety of point has led to the search for new tools for with which to create a response from the museum, often through popular culture. The introduction of new ideas, such as how archaeological heritage collections are presented and interpreted, the forms of exposition, the departure from traditional forms of display, which maintain a distance. The factors above diametrically changed the notion of the museum itself, the exhibition and the museum object, the need to be adapted to, they need to be adapted to contemporary needs. And now I will present you some examples of innovative archaeological expositions in Poland. I'm addressing not only archaeological museums, as I said, only archaeological expositions, and mainly focus my attention on changes in exhibition modes and archaeological exposition. In general, can be said that you know, archaeological museums in Poland are backwarded compared to different Western countries. And what should be blamed for the situation is, I think, that the system of financing of those institutions that is now by local governments. However, some general changes as far as sensory tourism and census contact with the past and heritage are observable, but not in all museums, but in some cases, and they indicate the slow but good change and good evolution to follow. And first exposition is to follow the traces of the European identity of Cracow. And as one can read in a tourist brochure, it's a place where the magic atmosphere is created by modern technology, offering a visitor a different perspective of the confirmation with history and monuments. In 2010, the Historical Museum of the City of Cracow opened its brand new exhibition in the excavated underground of the Market Square. And this museum is the result of many years of archaeological works undertaken in the very core of history of Cracow, and they're close to 800 years since its location. And the archaeologists reached the base level, indicating the fierce human activity in this area around 8 meters below the present surface of the market. And the museum encompasses 700 archaeological pieces, 500 digital molds of buildings, 600 3D digital molds of city structures in the time span of last 2,000 years. During the visit, we can admire medieval city stalls, cemeteries, cobblestone streets, jewelry, and hundreds of artifacts, wooden chests, and enriched with multimedia presentation, 3D models, and holograms. So in this kind of narrative museums, we can see also the construction and architecture relics that are presented in situ. You can see it here, that are presented in situ. Many light and sounds installation, multimedia, interactivity, participation. And you can also choose three different roads to visit this exhibition. Another exhibition I would like to show is the Mazovian Center of Metallurgy from the town of the Eras Daybreak. It was opened in 2014 as a new exhibition introduced and brings closer the general public one of the major discoveries of post-war archaeology, the Mazovian Center of Metallurgy in existence 20 centuries ago. And the presentation brings together in a balanced way state of the art, technology, and time-honored methods of museum displays to convey the excitement and richness of themes that are inherent to its subject. Thanks to the use of innovative forms of visual communication and design, the visitors to the exhibition are offered an intimate experience of the narration. The setting is created by original artifacts from archaeological excavations made in the region. The combined interpretation create a broad overview of the Mazovian Center of Metallurgy, the iron smelting and iron working pieces, the process, the daily life of settlement, and the wider historical context of this fragment of prehistory. And the exhibition incorporates many historical reconstructions in 3D, drawings, films, and multimedia resources to assist and enhance the visitor's experience of the prehistoric past. A special place is taken by holographic reconstruction of the glass beaker. So you can see here with painted figures of Roman gladiators. Another highlight of the exhibition is an interactive 360 degrees video of scenes from the life of an ancient prehistoric archaeological settlement in which the visitors are free to adjust the perspective and navigate within the recorded space. And this is the first time that this technology has been used in Poland in a museum exhibition. So another attractions include full reconstruction. So you can see on this picture, full reconstruction of the Roman legionary outfit and weapons informed by archaeological research, and the outfit of an affluent member of society. Another exposition is the Blue Lamp Runaway in Gdańsk. And what is important here is an interesting example of an effective use of smells in heritage tourism that may be found in this exposition. And this reconstruction of medieval Hanseatic street from the turn of the 14th and 15th century with workshops, stalls and baths. And thanks to multimedia installation using sounds and smell, it has become an interesting emotional space where you can enjoy its material content. You may hear the shouting and noises of the ancient inhabitants and smell the intriguing scents and odors. Here a multi-sensual experience recreates some aspects of the material, but also of the immaterial landscape of the past. Another exhibition is the exposition in Archaeological Open Air Museum Carpathian Troy in Strzemice, and it's a kind of narrative museum that tells the story of Carpathian Troy since its beginning through some scenes reconstructing the lives of inhabitants and some turning points in their existence, as it is known from archaeological evidence. And artifacts are connected with histories. They are not presented for the artifact's sake, but they are used to tell the story. And we can hear also sounds and music. Artifacts are presented in very aesthetic ways using multimedia devices. And this exhibition supplements the Open Air Museum in Karpacka Troja. Also, Poznań Archaeological Museum that contains a collection of 42,000 rare and mystifying objects that chart life in ancient Egypt and prehistoric Poland. And this is the first part of the museum takes you through the earliest settlement in the region with life-size features as well as miniature dioramas depicting life from the Stone Age to the Iron Age, and the other permanent exhibit, Death and Life in Ancient Egypt, features more than 100 rare pieces from a granite obelisk of Ramses II to the mummified remains of a woman named Hat. And the 3D films about the selected most precious artifacts from the museums are accessible on the museum website. In addition, the digital documentation produced under the project was made accessible in multimedia kiosk and at the exhibition dedicated to the history of the region. So here you can see, this museum also have a rich educational program for kids and for school children. And you can see here, it's very interesting because the exhibitions were adapted for visually impaired children, impaired people with Braille alphabet, so it's quite democratizing the museum context. Another exhibition I'd like to show you is a multimedia historical exhibition, The Slavic Myth. So under, you can see this, it was located in this building, so under the dome-shaped construction, each visitor have a chance to experience the world of Slavic tribes. And this was a multimedia exhibition illustrating the world of the magic and beliefs, the world of craftsmen, and farmers, the miniature, and the world of the afterlife, which the Slav believed in. So it is exposition fully based on reconstruction and replicas. Okay, there was no original artifacts, no kind of narrative exposition. Music accompanied this exhibitions and things like that. And it was a private initiative made by private firm and by historical reenactors. So I guess just also, because the time is closing to the end, show the virtual museum in Chodnik, and also Archaeological Reserve Janusz Losy in Poznań, that is a branch of the Poznan Archaeological Museums, and this newly created building houses an enormous archaeological excavation with perfect preserved relics of a timber and stone defensive structures from the 9th century, the wall that served the stronghold of the first rulers of the Piast dynasty. And here visitors can admire the great work of medieval engineering thanks to the multimedia. Everyone has a unique opportunity to explore the history of this place from various angles and perspectives. So this is an example of decentralization, kind of decentralization of museums and also in situ preservation. And I will now summarize selected, just to close it to the end, to summarize selective constitutive elements of sensory tourism presented the archaeological museums and archaeological exhibitions in Poland. As I have already said, some significant changes in exhibition strategy and forms of expositions as far as sensory tourism is being concerned have taken place. It then includes such elements as multisensoriality, that is possibility to experience the past through the senses. Also, aesthetization of the past in a case, in a sense of producing a whole, but also using of senses to experiencing these expositions, also the beautification of the past. Another element is interactive contact with the past, also with participation, direct personal and physical contact with the past, time travel idea, that is observer possibility to be traveling to different historical reality. Also, edutainment, so this linking education with entertainment, also entertainment, and ritualization, because immerse oneself in different reality, different past reality, and also commercialization. I think it is very, very, very important. Element is a sense of being attractive, sense of being competitive, also that consuming pleasures that I think that in today's society appears to be a kind of sixth sense. And also at the very end I would like to mention some elements that are quite popular, because I call it beyond the museum walls. This is a very, very important question, a very important issue of spreading of festivals of living history that are very often organized by museums. And that is tied to a new tourism, mostly based on emotions. So it refers to both to the visualization of the past in the form of reenacted activities of life in the past, in the front of live audience. So, moreover, it is not about passive observing what is performed, by mainly it is about an active participation in the stage events from the past. Okay, thank you so much for your attention.